The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. There were some present at that time who told Jesus of the Galileans whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. And he answered them, "Do you think that these Galileans were worse sinners than all the other Galileans because they suffered thus? I tell you, no. But unless you repent, you will all likewise perish. Are those 18 upon whom the Tower of Siloam fell and killed them, do you think that they were worse offenders than all the others who dwelt in Jerusalem? I tell you, no. But unless you repent, you will all likewise perish." And he told this parable. A man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came seeking fruit on it and found none. And he said to the vine dresser, "Lo, these 3 years I have come seeking fruit on this fig tree, and I find none. Cut it down. Why should it use up the ground?" And he answered him, "Let it alone, sir, this year also, till I dig about it and put on manure. And if it bears fruit next year, it will be good. But if not, you can cut it down." The Gospel of the Lord. My dear children, my dear brothers and sisters, sometimes we hear about some people unjustly killed. So many murders take place everywhere in the world. Immediately, what do we think? So they were sinners, that's why they died, we think. At other times, there are accidents taking place. So many road accidents. Or sometimes natural calamities, tsunami, flood, earthquake. So many things are happening. So immediately some people will say, those people were sinners, that's why they died like that. Something similar was reported to Jesus, and Jesus says, don't think those who died are worse, you are better, not at all. Every death calls each and every one of us to repent. We must be converted. Whenever we hear about some people suffering, what we should decide? Lord, I don't know how many days, how many weeks, how many months you are going to allow me to live on this earth. Let me repent and bear fruit. Every death, every tragedy, whether just or unjust, every suffering is a call to conversion. In this context only, Jesus told a little story. There was agriculturist, a farmer, who had lot of fig trees in his vineyard. The fig tree is not for leaves it is planted. It is for fruits. He has been looking for fruit after it has sufficiently grown year after year. First year he comes, second year he comes, third year he comes, no fruit at all. He is so disappointed. So he tells the gardener, what is the use of having this tree in the vineyard? Better cut it down, it is simply occupying the space. Then the gardener tells him, tells the master, "Sir, give me one more year. I will dig and manure it. If it bears fruit, okay. Otherwise, we can cut it down." Jesus is telling that to you and me. The Lord is looking for fruit. Maybe your parents, your relatives, your teachers are thinking that you have to study well. Some of the people get marks like ranks. Single digit mark or not at all studying properly. But we should not disappoint God, disappoint our parents. So many years we have grown. Not only 3 years, 10 years God is looking for fruit from you, from me. More than 50 years the Lord is looking for fruit. Every day is a day of mercy. Do not forget it. Bear abundant fruit. The glory of God is children who are alive and active. Give your best. If you work hard and get 60% also, doesn't matter. But don't be lazy. The Lord wants us to bear fruit. We don't know how many days we are going to live. As long as we live, let us bring joy in the lives of people. Nobody should shed tears because of our conduct. Your parents, brothers and sisters must rejoice over you. You should live in such a way that wherever you are present, you are a joy and blessing to the people. May the grace of this Eucharist do the same. How much John Paul II made so many people happy, gave hope to the people, broke himself as this Eucharistic bread is broken on the altar. How much Jesus our Lord was a joy to people, going about doing always good. We are called to imitate Pope John Paul II, imitate Jesus Christ, who was fruitful, who was kind, generous, gentle, giving himself totally for others. Amen.